Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss a project related to agriculture and farming. In this project, whenever our soil gets dry, a notification will be sent to the mobile application, and from the mobile application we can turn on the water pump to water the plants. So here we have a IoT board. This one is our IoT development board. This is Nokia LCD screen. This board has a Wi-Fi enabled chip called NodeMCU. Here we have taken a wet pot and a dry pot. This one we will treat as a water tank. Here inside it we have a pump. This pump is powered by the IoT development board and it is connected through these pins. This one is our soil moisture sensor and this one is its module, and we have connected it to the IoT development board. So now let's first see the demonstration. We have presently powered the IoT development board using micro USB cable. We can also power the board using 9 volt DC adapter. So this one is our mobile application. It is based on Blink server. Blink is an intermediate server that helps in connecting the IoT development boards and mobile applications. So now we have presently have created a project inside the Blink application. So now we will place the sensor inside the wet pot. So presently the pot is wet, it has some water. So now we will again place the moisture sensor from the wet pot to the dry pot and we will see a notification in our mobile. See, here we get a notification. Okay, so this one is a notification that we have got when we place the soil moisture sensor in a dry pot. So now we have got the notification. Now we can switch on the water pump. We can control it from the mobile application. So as we can see, the pump has transferred some water from the water tank to the pot. So this was the demonstration and practical working. Now we will see the program and the logic behind it. So this is our full code. It has been written in Arduino development environment and this one is our Arduino software. Here we have used some libraries. The starting two libraries are inbuilt libraries and we don't need to download them from the internet. This library needs to be downloaded from the internet as it is an external library. So for downloading we just need to copy the name and then we need to search it on Google. The first link is for the library. So here is the download button. So now it is downloading and it will save in the computer. So after downloading we have to add the library inside the software. We have to go to sketch, include library, add.zip library. We have already saved the library inside the folders. So now we have added the library into the software. After the library, we have an authentication token. This one is the authentication token that we need to be added in the software, in the code. This authentication token is needed by the Blink server for the communication between the IoT development board and the mobile application. We will later see how we can add the authentication token. After that, we have declared the sensor pin number. This is the pin at which our soil moisture module will connect to. These are some variables for storing the states related information, that present state is 0 or the last state was 1 or 0. After that, we have initialized the Blink server. Here we have added the password for the Wi-Fi. This one is the Wi-Fi name and this one is the Wi-Fi password. We need to change it accordingly as per our router settings or internet settings. After that, we have declared the sensor pin as input. Sensor pin is the pin at which the module is connected, soil moisture module. After that, we have started the application. This statement started the application, mobile application, and gets connect to the server. After that, we are reading from the sensor pin that the module is transmitting 1 or 0. If the module transmits a value of 1024, that means it needs water. Soil moisture sensor that we have transmits a value between 0 and 1024. 1024 value means there is a need of water. That means our water plant is dry. So if we get a value of 1024 from the module sensor, then we will transmit a notification, water your plants. So as if we didn't get 1024, that means we don't need to water the plant. So does not need water. So this was the code. Now we will set up the mobile application. Our mobile application is Blink, BLYNK. It can be downloaded from the Google Play Store. After opening the app, we need to create a new project. Module name. Create. Now authentication token has been sent to the Gmail address. This one is the Gmail address that we use to login into the Blink application. When we download the application, we need to sign in with a Gmail ID. So this one is a Gmail ID that we use to sign in. So now we will navigate to the Gmail address. So this is our Gmail ID. Now we will see if we have got the mail from the Blink. Now we have got the email from the Blink application. This one is the email. Here is the authentication token. We need to copy it. Now we will paste it inside the program. Now we will continue the setup in the mobile application. After we have created a new project, we need to click on the black space. Now we will add some items. So we need to add a notification item. So it has been added to the black space. We can see it in the corner. The next item will be switch button. So we have added a notification and a button. We need to do some settings. The pin number is D8 for the switch. This is the pin number at which the relay module which is powering the water pump is connected. The relay module is connected inside the IoT development board. Now we will upload the code in the IoT development board. Before uploading, we need to select the board name. It should be NodeMCU. After that, we need to select the COM port. The COM port will only appear after connecting the micro USB cable. After that, we will click on upload button. The compiling process will take some time, and after compiling, it will upload the code to the development board. So for the connection on the IoT development board, here we have some pins, pinout. Here we will connect the sensor module, and here we have some pins for the water pump. So we will connect the module here. And the pins of the water pump here. The code is uploaded. Now we will test the application. Here we have the mobile application. Now we will transfer the soil moisture sensor from the wet port to the dry port, and we will see a notification on the mobile. So we have got a notification. Now we will switch on the motor from the mobile application, the water pump. We can see it has started filling the water. Now let's try with this one. So this type of project we can use in agriculture or gardening or in farming. Using the same logic and designing principle, we can create more applications like plant monitoring or controlling irrigation methods, smart irrigation system, or a house monitoring system. So this type of application we can generate using the soil moisture sensor and the water pump. I hope you like our video. Thank you.